Hi students, hope all of you are fine. Have you written all the question answers in your notebook? In the previous videos, we discussed about the geographical features of Delhi, the Rajputs, and about the dynasties of Sultanate period. Do you remember the trick I told you? Messi Kohli too slow. Messi M for Mamulk. Second one, Kohli K for Khalji. Two, third dynasty Tughlaq, and slow, S for Sayyid and L for Lodi. Next, today we will discuss about the expansion of power of Delhi Sultans to other part of Indian subcontinent. All of you know the first dynasty of Sultanate period, the Mamluk dynasty. Who established Mamluk dynasty? Qutbuddin Aibak, the prominent ruler in Mamluk dynasty. He resisted the Mongolian Emperor Genghis Khan and prevented their invasion to Delhi. After Qutbuddin Aibak, Iltutmish assumed power and conquered Multan, Lahore, and Bengal. He introduced a uniform monetary system, that is, money system, in the regions under his control. Tanga and Jital were the newly introduced coins. Tanga was made of gold and Jital was made of silver. Then Sultana Razia, daughter of Iltutmish, became the woman ruler of Delhi. She was known for being the only woman ruler of Delhi. She lost her power because some nobles protested it. As she was a woman, the male-dominated society was against her. Next, Balban was the ruler who resumed to power after the reign of Iltutmish. Which was the next dynasty after Mamluk? Yes, Khalji dynasty. The Khalji dynasty succeeded the Mamluk dynasty. The most prominent among the Khalji ruler was Alauddin Khalji. It was during his reign that the south and west region of India came under the Delhi Sultanate. The first region came under his control was Gujarat. The long coastal line is a peculiar feature of Gujarat. All of you know what is coastal line. Coastal line means the land along the seashore. Because of this coastal line, several seaports existed in Gujarat. With the conquest of Gujarat, these seaports came under the control of Alauddin Khalji. He imported fine horses from Iraq through these seaports. This strengthened his military power and he conquered the regions in the southern and western India. He made many reforms like price control, market control, and food at low price. And he was able to resist the invasion from Mongols. The Khalji dynasty was succeeded by Tughlaq dynasty. Muhammad bin Tughlaq was the important ruler of Tughlaq dynasty. To rule more efficiently, he shifted the capital from Delhi to Devagiri and renamed it as Daulatabad. Muhammad bin Tughlaq thought that all the regions could be controlled effectively by shifting the capital from Delhi to Daulatabad. Later, he found that shifting the capital from Delhi to Daulatabad was not practical. So he withdrew the decision, but he was not able to resist the Mongol Timur. Timur invaded Delhi recklessly and plundered it, and appointed Khizr Khan to rule Punjab. Khizr Khan was the founder of Sayyid dynasty. The Sayyid dynasty was usurped by Lodi dynasty. Ibrahim Lodi was the prominent ruler of Lodi dynasty. Due to his arrogance, his nobles and people conspired him, and thus the Sultanate period came to an end. Today we discussed about each dynasty, their prominent rulers and their expansion of power. First one, Mamluk dynasty. Prominent rulers were Qutbuddin Aibak, Iltutmish, Sultan Arasiya and Balban. The coins were introduced, uniform monetary system was introduced, Tanga and Jital coins were used during that time. Next one was Khalji dynasty. Important ruler Alauddin Khalji conquered Gujarat through seaports. He imported horses and strengthened his military power. After that, Khalji dynasty, Muhammad bin Tughlaq was the prominent ruler. Then he shifted Delhi to Devagiri and renamed it as Daulatabad. Next one was Sayyid and Lodi dynasty. Kesar Khan was the founder of Sayyid dynasty and Ibrahim Lodi was the prominent ruler of Lodi dynasty. Hope all of you understood all these things. If you have any doubt regarding this video, please ask through WhatsApp group. Thank you.